In this video, we are going to see SR fructum. In the previous video, what we have seen is RS fructum. Okay, so where S is set and R is reset, and when both are zero, when S and the R is zero, the Q and Q bar will remain the previous state. So whatever is there in the previous output, say for example, when Q is one, when both the inputs are one, it remembers the one. When Q is zero, it remembers the when both input R and S are zero, it remembers. That's what we have seen. Say when R is zero and S is one, you will have the output Q as one. That means it is storing one. Okay, it is storing. Then when you change the both the input to 0, 0, it remembers. See here, there is no change in the output. It remembers the previous state. That is it, which is said to be storing the value. Then when S is zero and R is one, that is reset. The flip-flop is reset. Reset means it is clear. So Q is zero. That means it is storing the value of zero, and Q bar will be one because it is the opposite. Then when both are zero, see, there is no change because it is saving the previous value. When both the inputs are zero, it is said to be the flip-flop is storing the previous, the value which is stored in it. Then when both are one, both become zero, which is not allowed. It is a forbidden condition because Q is here, it is Q and Q bar, which is nothing but complement of Q. In which case, what happened when Q is one, then Q bar is the complement of this, which is nothing but it must be zero. When this is zero, this is one. Where it should not be both one or it should not be both zero. That condition is said to be forbidden. So when you give both one, it happens to be both zero, which is not allowed. Okay, now we'll go to the next one, which is RS flip-flop. Okay, now SR flip-flop. SR flip-flop is just the reverse of RS flip-flop. Here, when both are one, it remains. The previous, it remembers the state. That is, no change will be, no change in the previous state when both are one. But when both are zero, that is forbidden condition. Both will have one, and which is not allowed. So, so here when S is one and R is zero, what happened when S is one and here R is zero? The output will be, imagine it is Q and one. So what happened? This Q goes here and for R here. So Q is zero, say S is one and Q is zero. Let us take this first condition. The Q is zero, zero goes here and R is zero. So zero, zero, it is zero and it becomes one. Okay, because it is an AND operation. So zero into zero, zero becomes one. Whereas this one goes here and already S is one. So one into one, it is one, it becomes zero. So that is what we are seeing here. Then when both are one, let us imagine, the previous output is 0 and 1. Now we apply 1, 1. When this is 1 and this is 1, what happens? Already it is 0 and 1, isn't it? So 1 for this, 1 goes here. 0 and 1, it is multiplication, 0. The output will become, okay. 1 and 1, let us consider from here, 0. This 0 goes here, 0 into 1. For this also, yes, here it is Q bar is 1 and here it is 1 into 1, it is 1 and the output will be 0. So Q is 0, still remind that. Then here 0 and then 1, 0 into 1, 0. So the output will be 1. So again, now there is no change. Here it is 0 and 1, the same thing. Then when you give 0 and 1, let us imagine you are giving 0 and then 1 as the output. Now 0, 1. Now here, imagine you have a 0. So what happened? 0 into 1, it is 0 and output will be 1. Okay, so if you take the input to be 1, so 1 and then here 1 and here 0. So 1 and 0, it is 0 and output will be 1. So it depends upon what input we are giving. Now we'll see that with the, and when both are 0, you will get 1. Here output 1, which is forbidden because Q bar is a complement of 1, which is not allowed. Now I'll just draw the circuit and I'll show you. See here. And now we'll have text. LED, and here we have input. Now, two inputs. So this is yes. We write it down. This is yes, and this is R. And here we have Q, and this is Q bar. Okay. Now we'll apply the yes. Now when both are zero, see here this one. This is not allowed. Okay, now we'll say 1 and 0. 1 and 0. When S is 1, you have Q is 0 and 1, which is the reverse of the RS flip-flop. Okay, there when S is 1, Q will be 1. But here, when S is 1, Q is 0. Then, when both are 1, it remembers the previous state. See, there is no change in this. Now, let me take here R1 and S0. Now, Q is 1. Now, when I give both 1, see, there is no change. It remembers the previous state. Now, when I give both 0, both will be 1, which is not allowed. So, this is the SR flip-flop.